From San Francisco, welcome to Tech Nation, Americans and Technology, with your interview host, Dr. Moira Young. Someone wants to spread a virus.
Scientists have isolated a gene with
which increase a person's likelihood of developing some retail
diseases, such as breast cancer, and very high cancer, cancer.
Computer viruses. Are they scary? Aren't they? First Couch is the publisher of Fibrosis Newsletter,
disease,
publication aimed at virus writers, antivirus writers, and the computer security industry. The newsletter actually publishes the program instructions for frequent interesting viruses. It's not illegal.
The necessary funding to take
response to
the most recent report
that is mail
present claims
by
I'm going to Insurance is a very broad term because there are all kinds of entities that provide insurance, some of which The great news is that the gene was found, and great another part of the aspect of financing, and that is, there's this other part of AT that actually gets a lot more attention than our little rare disease that affects kids. And that's carrying one copy of this disease, being a carrier. My wife and I obviously are, being a carrier causes my to have a higher incidence of cancer. What was incentive is still being debated. When this was just a rare disease and there was no real easy way to get a definite answer. As you can imagine, if you're studying this, one particular researcher in the U.S. and a couple overseas, their evidence seems to indicate that cancer is a higher rate of carrier. Nothing like the kids in the disease, but nevertheless, it's genes in the carrier state, and those people, as you know, the whole of
There are people programming viruses.
And I'm talking about studies for
There are other people who program viruses. What virus do like? And they have large collectors. And they like to run the chain trade and so on. I'm concerned for them to program on the virus. So that they can use the trade for games for education and viral organizations. And we're talking about I've seen two examples of research software trouble in-house
I would think become a fascination.
Also, maybe two or three programs are on virus to try and control it. Or at least to try and work out some principles that you work on.
Well, I have to say
why shouldn't it be interesting? And it is interesting. I mean, we should have the argument from obviously this is rather interesting. I mean, why do we have 1800 MS-DOS viruses? The numbers vary depending on your culture. Because the numbers become so large, where obviously this actually fits the interest of Walla. Because it's almost a full time
application.
I have no idea.
Come on.
I don't know who wrote it. Maybe someone else will write it. I think it'd be dangerous for someone to submit to it. And
I respect that as a virus.
A lot of down. solid activity, so you might support it.
Family.
I think what's really important to emphasize is everyone that's listening is that this can happen to anyone.
National breast cancer coalition.
Dr. Collins always says that 4 or 5
this catch
and that the concern is to let time and at first not want the fact that it can happen much later in life.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Senators Mack.
While hearing a story about a very rare disease, sad story.
As you know, the National Breast Cancer Coalition is a grassroots organization dedicated to the eradication of breast cancer.
We didn't know we did, but just 2 years ago,
my
wife and I discovered
we
that
are 350 organizational members and 41,000 individual members strong and growing. And our members across the country, especially in California and Florida, appreciate the support that we have received from
lack of
you in our
campaign.
One of our prime goals is to increase the influence of breast cancer.
We thought we had a perfect family, and we thought we did everything right.
And we appreciate your willingness to include our perspective on the complex privacy and discrimination issues that were discussed
today. You asked Dr.
Collins a question about money.
It's an inherited disease that affects all races, all sexes, all countries, all ethnic origins equally. It's recessive, which means that the wife and I had carriers with the one copy that damaged the
gene.
And even then, by marrying and having kids, we had a 1 in 4 chance of having a child. This will happen
by the year
2000,
in the next 3 years, we should spend $2.6 billion on breast cancer research. That's $2.6 billion on living with the disease.
I try to imagine that the senator would have
a
family. Them. screening on the
I'm going to Put this into perspective. This task was
They only identify women who are at increased risk of breast cancer. Yet those women make up 5 to 10% of women who get breast cancer. As Dr. Cloud mentioned, women who test negative must still be told that doesn't mean they're home for breast cancer. They still face almost a 1-in-8 lifetime risk of breast cancer. They have to be told to follow proper guidelines. And most importantly, because I've read otherwise in some news reports, we have to make certain people recognize that it's not a test to detect breast cancer, and it's not a test to prevent breast cancer. It's not a test to cure the disease. It's a test to show you may have predisposition to get a breast cancer. Now, women with strong family histories who test positive for the disease, the effects of this must be very careful, because tests may tell these women with strong family histories that they have a 85% chance of getting a disease for which we don't know how to prevent. We don't know how to tell these women to prevent breast cancer, and we don't know how to cure the disease. We have to carefully monitor these women signs of cancer development, but we really don't have any methods of protection that work for every woman. And we don't know how well methods of protection we do have will work with women with strong family histories. There are some studies that indicate they may not work. We, in this area, as in too many areas of breast cancer, have too little information. But breast cancer patients and their families want more tests available. But they want a valid and reliable test available. They want to know whether this test in fact works. They want to know what counseling will work and whether counseling will work. It's imperative that this testing be done within research protocols. That is extremely important to us. We want to make certain that these research protocols are available around the country so that all of these families who want to participate can. Now, I'm not talking about the snapshot study dealing with the Ashkenazi Jewish situation. I'm talking about the broader follow-up studies. And I'm talking about the studies for tests for mutations aside from the Ashkenazi situation. I make a plea here today to women across this country. Please participate in these research programs. Because while genetic predisposition may impact a small percentage of women with breast cancer, we believe that these discoveries will lead to even broader answers to this disease. And women with strong family histories, women owe it all to participate in these research programs so that we can get the answers that will help all of us and help all of our children. Of course, this raises insurance issues on a number of levels. One level is coverage for participation in research programs. You've heard a great deal of concerns about insurance companies not wanting to cover experimental treatment as a problem they want to cover participating and costs associated with participating in high-quality research to determine whether something is experimental, whether it's experimental. We need to make certain that insurance companies and third-party payers cover participation in clinical trials that make economic sense in the case. We support the guidelines that were adopted by Dr. Collins mentioned, that were adopted by the Health Working Group and the National Action Plan on Breast Cancer. We believe that we have to deal with insurance discrimination for pre-decision to disease now. I was also going to talk to you about the article in the Sunday New York Times magazine. My mother, father, uncle, and everyone cousins had died young of heart disease. That officer decided he didn't want to have a cat, and that he didn't want to have a cat. But it is mentioned, individuals who did not get their name in these publications. I was also at the July hearing, and I was one of the women who did not want their name in these publications. I know too many women who were involved in that situation. We're not just talking about testing. I've had representatives from insurance companies say that we're not going to make
these
more
tests,
but they'll ask
out and control
each tax
credit.
And they also will ask to have history information. Often that's
different norms
that
are going to be created for certain because it may very well be that there ought to be available to families, such as yours,
policy cannot afford to be
issues related
specifically with
AK,
and that we have to
build
that
ought to be tested and mailed and so forth. So there really is a real question. And when you get into the issue about the cancer aspect of it, because really, in some ways, it's similar to the RCA 1G, where we know we're alive. Well, we probably need to pass out on cancer. At this point, there is a lot we don't risk cancer. I guess, from a rule perspective, I come down on this question of who has the right to make a determination about the testing, frankly, where it really comes down to me, because it's really up to the individual or the family, I think. Dr. Collins and I had a conversation years ago.
Is grassroots
when I raised the question after the
T16
gene discovered that's the melanoma gene, if I've got the right.
We are 350
with my brother Michael,
who
died of melanoma, with the
melanoma
having been taken off my side 6 years ago.
Does
it make sense that, that I test for
one of the genes,
or should my son or daughter be tested for the melanoma gene? The question that is coming from is, if we do that, what have we learned and what have they learned? I'm not really sure how to do it, but I think that's exactly the reason
why we're
going
to
do the hearings that have the same spread as being your insurance list, your experience, your thoughts, and your ideas. And I think in the end, it's going to turn out to be very, very helpful.
I have a question that I can give you for breast cancer.
Thank you very much. I think you understood all the answers to the question that your master just asked about who really has the right. What you're saying is the individual has the right.
Breast cancer research program.
75 or 80 years old. There's not going to be maybe a lot you're going to do about whatever the genetic makeup is. But I think when you're a young person, when you're faced with a decision, it becomes very important to know what some of these things are. Would you agree with that? I mean, for you, it's important in your decision whether to have children and more children.
So for those other reasons, other than the cancer, the other is, as I mentioned, with 18 families, I think absolutely people have a right. If they have a child in their family somewhere, they have a right to go to their carrier and see what happens to all that. But on the cancer risk, the jury's still out. So wait 2 years to get to the bottom of whether there really is a cancer risk and there are things, or whether there are not things you can do about it. Some people say we shouldn't, yes, provide carrier testing for family members,
first of all,
or for even the general population, because there's nothing, it's premature, it would be misleading, it would lead people to think there was some reason to know it, and maybe there isn't a reason to know it yet. So I can understand that. I you know, to tell you the truth, what I would like best is that we just work harder and faster to find out if there's significance there and if there's something you can do about it. And then we won't have to have this debate. We'll just help people with their carriers and also tell them what to do.
Tell me one thing, if you will. What is the name of your foundation and what are you
just trying to help?
ADT Children's Project, 21645 Cartagena, Cartagena Drive, Boca Raton, Florida, 33428. Thanks, Bradley.
Well, let me just wish you all the best, all the luck in science and bring to bear on the beautiful field. Enjoy it. And certainly anything I can do to help, and I know that goes for Somber. We will.
Thank you. businessman. I have a businessman with an MBA from Harvard.